Not complaining each time when things don't work in their favor. as expected, they would always complain. But for me, it is not a do or die affair, it's a context. The World Congress took place, the panel came and conducted the World Congress, and everybody who wanted to participate. So if they choose not to participate, nobody's believing them. But for us, if they believe in the party and I say they are party men, we must work together. One person must emerge. But it is not by doing anything according to think that somebody will be edged out of nowhere. That is not possible. We'll go for the primary. Whoever that emerges, everybody should work together and support that person.
Thank you.
Yes. Let me just we have submitted our foundation from. We are not prepared for the primaries, and thereafter we have to face our government, which is the proposed Congress. I believe it will work out well. I believe that with the support we are getting, we hope to go from victorious. So we are happy what we have done. We are very much happy, and we think that it is important for us, all of us in PDP, to work as a team. It doesn't matter who emerges. What matters is the party, because the supremacy of the party should be paramount to everybody. Party supreme all the time. It's not just good for you to say party supreme. At the end of the day, you don't believe in that that supremacy of the party. So it goes beyond you saying it. For me, and that's why you can see that our team, we are going from one local government to the other to solicit for the delegate to support us. We are not just saying endorse us. We are not saying any good to go and endorse us. We are saying the delegates should, because we believe that we have something to offer. We believe that we have the capacity to face the other party for the general election. So whoever that emerges, we believe that God in our side, that we will emerge victorious, come to the date of November 2014. So we submitted our form to show you that we just don't pick up the form, but completed it. And if you see those who nominated me, these are the leaders of the state, these are the leaders of the party. If you check everybody's nomination form, you look at those who nominated each of the Guba aspirants, then that will tell you where the leadership of the party is going to.
Your Excellency, sir, a group of governorship aspirants were here in Abuja yesterday to call for your disqualification. What do you make of the situation?
Well, I don't know why they should call for my disqualification. Did they think that if you disqualify me, would then make them to win the election? But you see, in Nigeria, we must have the spirit of accepting whoever that wins. It's not every time if you don't win, you begin to complain. You said you are not going to participate in the Congress, and you did not participate in the Congress, and you are not calling for a cancellation of the Congress of what you voluntarily did not participate. In the first instance, they came to court in Abuja to seek an order to stop the Congress. They called the Senate that matter. They came to Port Harcourt and filed another matter that the Congress should not hold. They did not get the order. They went and tried to burn the party secretariat. The party secretariat did not burn. So having said all those options, they now came up to say, we are withdrawn from the Congress. Those of us who know what policy is all about, we participate in the Congress. And everybody saw it clearly. I hear they say that the Deputy Executive Secretary of UBEC, since he worked under me as a minister, he should not have. I did not appoint him. I'm not the president that appoints. Mr. President appointed Deputy Executive Secretary of UBEC. I'm not the party who nominate those who are going to conduct the election. Whoever you bring, if you like go to the moon and bring anybody, our team will win, because you must be on ground for you to win. There's no sentiment about it. This is not where I come from here, I don't come from here. Go to all the local government, there's no way you will not feel our presence. That's what they call grassroots. It's not a question of staying in Abuja every day to hold a press conference. Learn how to lose and be a good loser, and come back and work for the interest of the party. Nobody will disqualify me. The court has not been indicted of any offense, so why would anybody disqualify me? If it confirms does that mean that you win the election? It does not. So find how you think that the people will support you. And if at the end of the day you win, I have volunteered that if anybody emerges, I will be the campaign manager. And if I also emerge, I also believe that the Chiroto cannot like me. We have only one opening, which is the All People's Congress. Our energy should be geared towards defeating the APC in the general election. Not just every day spending our energy, week. I'm at home every day going to all the local government. You are here in Abuja, so week. That will not make it to win the election.
Okay, tell me about
winning the election. What do you think of the candidacy of Yemi Osunbajo?
Sincerely, Chief Nelson Wike is the candidate to beat. That's the truth. Because the man had worked hard, he's on ground, and looking at the array of supporters he has, the key stakeholders in PDP are with him. But you know, the truth is that PDP, as we speak, is not a government house River State. We want to reclaim government house River State. And I've said this several times, every election has its strategy. We believe that with Chief Nelson Wike, we can reclaim government house River State. So please, other aspirants, bury the hatchet. Let us work together and ensure that we reclaim Government House River State for PDP. It's important.
So how much support are you offering?
Oh, 100%.